I can't remember what he looked like. I think I loved him. But when you can't put him in your mind, you begin to doubt it. That's the trouble with Port and Lemon. Truth pours out.
There you are, Lieutenant. We were just saying how proud we all are of the job you uniformed chaps are doing. Our youngers will be joining up next Easter, just in time for the big push, I hope, eh? Well, tell your men that one day the bells will ring to tell us it's all over. Till then, those of us still at home are with you every step of the way.
What does that mean? Dulce, pulce.
Dulce et decorum est pro patria mori. Means it is sweet and honourable to die for your country.
I'm glad it's in Latin. If that were in English, there's a good few widows would laugh at it.
Which way's your lodgings?
My lodgings? My lodgings won't do you any good. My landlady's a dragon. 50 times worse than my mom.
Shall we go for a walk? I don't fancy saying goodnight just yet. You?
Any for them.
I was thinking about a man in my platoon. Wrote the same letter to his wife every week for 2 years.
How do you know he did?
Because I had to censor it. Every week I had to read all their letters.
Who read yours?
Nobody. They rely on our sense of honour.
You lot make me sick. I suppose nobody else has got a sense of honour.
Short ass buggers, the Scots. Can I see you again?
Maybe.
We can have a bit to eat in Edinburgh and then go somewhere on the train after Sunday.
Billy Pryor.
Sarah.
I've been confined to the hospital for 2 weeks.
This is the army, Mr. Pryor. There are rules. Apparently, Matron saw you in town. You weren't wearing your hospital armband.
I was looking for a girl. which, as you may or may not know, is not made any easier by walking around with a band on your arm saying I'm a loony.
Yes, well, I'm sure Major Bryce will reconsider his action if you give him good reason.
Aren't you going to ask me if I got one?
One what?
Girl. A woman. Woman.
No, I wasn't.
Well, I did. She's a munitionette. She's very pretty.
Mr. Pryor, would you like to leave it for today?
No.
All right. Let's go back to the time immediately following the April 23rd attack. Have you made any progress beyond that?
No. I don't want to talk about that.
What do you want to talk about?
Something you said's been bothering me. You said officers don't suffer from mutism.
That's right. Officers tend to suffer from stammering. It's the lower ranks who suffer from mutism.
Why?
We don't know. Even the dreams of officers, and believe me, I've studied thousands, tend to be more elaborate than those of the other ranks.
Rather have their dreams than mine.
How do you know? You don't remember yours.
I refuse to believe that General Haig's dreams are more elaborate than those of the lowest ranker. All those noodle-brained dimwits who think they're born to lead as if God gave them a birthright over others.
Well, you've certainly conquered your mutism, Mr. Pryor. Interesting, isn't it, that you're one of the very few people here who doesn't stammer?
I think it's even more interesting that you do.
Is that the end of my appointment for today, Mr. Pryor?
Maybe you're the one who's ill.
We want to play in cricket and every kind of game. A tip-top out and follow, you men have made your name. But now your country calls you to play your part in war.
And this is good. Red lips are not so red as the stained stones kissed by the English dead. It's absolutely perfect. And, this one, Dead Youth. I thought Anthem.
This one? Anthem for Dead Youth.
We'll work at it, and then bring it back and we'll have a go at it together. Is it traumatic for you?
No. Writing is like exorcism.
Well, if you ever get back to the front, at least it'll be good for your poetry.
Yes. Yes, it would. Guess. Quick, boys. An ecstasy of fumbling, fitting the clumsy helmets just in time. But someone still was yelling out and stumbling and floundering like a man in fire or lime. Dim, through the misty panes and thick green light, as under a green sea, I saw him drowning. In all my dreams, before my helpless sight, he plunges at me, guttering, choking, drowning. If in some smothering dreams you two could pace behind the wagon that we flung him in and watch the white eyes writhing in his face, his hanging face like a devil sick of sin, if you could hear at every jolt the blood come gurgling from the froth-corrupted lungs, obscene as cancer, bitter as the cud of vile incurable sores on innocent tongues, my friend, you would not tell with such high zest to children ardent for some desperate glory the old lie, dulce et decorum est, pro patria mori.
Came to say sorry about this morning.
We all know if you wanted to be really offensive, you could have done better than that.
But I was stupid. going on like that.
Sit down.
You must be tired.
Tired of paperwork.
I think we could try hypnosis now.
Now?
Yes, we're not likely to be interrupted. You might remember things. Did that worry you?
I want to remember. I know you think I'm always lying, but I want to remember.
Good.
Now it's frightening.
We're going to leave it if you want.
No. No, I can't pester you for it, then turn it down, can I? So, what do we do? Bless you, Jordan.
Now, sir.
What shall I do with this gobstopper?
Fuck. Fuck. Jesus fucking Christ.
Is that all?
All? Oh. It was traumatic by any standards. A bombardment? It's nothing.
Sorry.
It's all right. Other people's dreams. Let's get some fresh air. I wonder, what do you think happened?
When I couldn't remember, I thought it must have been my fault. I still don't understand why that made me break down.
A breakdown isn't a single traumatic event. It's erosion. Stress. Powerlessness.
But I was in charge. I was in command. I'm not the kind of person who collapses.
We all are. I know I could. I know I could.
I talk to the trees. But not being proper officer material, I don't stammer. He had very blue eyes, Sorden. We used to call him the Hun. Just wanted to say thank you.
Yes, well, it isn't over yet, Mr. Pryor.
No, at least I can talk about it. Can you?
I'm preparing reports for the medical board. You're due to appear next time.
I need to know what you want me to say.
Do you usually ask the patient?
No.
I'm not giving in.
All right.
What'll happen?
You'll get another period of sick leave. And then another, and so on, until the war ends.
And you'd despise me. What would you think? What do you think?
I think when you put on a uniform, in effect, you sign a contract. And you can't break it just because you change your mind. You do the job you said you'd do. That's the only way to achieve any influence or respect for your views.
The contract was broken by the government. I entered a war of liberation. That was my contract. It is now a war of aggression. And as a result of which, I've been dumped here with these creatures and judged a coward.
Your military cross rather speaks against that.
I will not go to a medical board that demands I recant.
He tries to behave as if we're equal, but in the end, he's a gold medalist of the Royal Society, and I left Cambridge without taking a degree. Now you're getting shows.
Do you talk about after the war?
No, I can't.
I'm going to keep pigs.
I won't recognize him. He will. What if he's not got any legs? I've got you these.
trouble, Tapper.
Nurse?
I'm sorry.
Passing bells is good. Well, I thought, solemn anger.
No. Monstrous anger is better.
You realize you contradict yourself by saying there's no consolation, and then you say there is.
Not consolation. Pride in sacrifice.
Isn't that consolation?
No. Even when courage is abused, it's still... Look, you do exactly the same thing. What's that if it's not pride in sacrifice?
All right. Point taken.
I changed the title, too. Anthem for Doomed Youth is stronger.
Is it going?
Look, he's here.
I'll be right back.
Don't try too hard.
What happened to Sunday?
I was laid back. They kept me in.
A bit strict? Your parents? You think I didn't know?
What was I doing, drooling?
You're not the first to take it off. Does that matter, Billy Pryor? I went to the medical hospital with Madge. And there's things that matter. This is just a kind of wound. Isn't it?
McLaughlin, Owen's hat!
Sassoon!
Yes! Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah. Get in the nose!
Oh, sorry. Can I have your hand?
Thank you. I'm fine.
Back here! How's that? Here!
We were in a cemetery when they bombed it. 47 pieces of gravestone. You try. 2 months on your belly with rest in peace stuck up your ass.
No permanent damage, anyway.
There's still the injury to the spine. I know what you want me to say. It's all in my mind. You think I'm saying I can't walk so as not to go back? Well, I'm not a coward.
No.
No.
I don't think you are either. Coward. Coward needs his legs.
Breathe. So, what do you think's wrong?
I don't know. I already stammer, and I'm getting a twitch.
Well, we've all got one of those.
We're isolated. That's our problem.
Isolated? I don't have a second to myself.
Exactly.
Peculiar, isn't it? In charge, but not in control.
You know what's wrong, don't you?
I'm getting shell-shocked by my patients.
My diagnosis, exactly. Your heart beats irregular, at least one extra systolic.
Psychosomatic.
Well, as we keep telling them, psychosomatic symptoms are real.
I'll be all right.
So will they, most of them.
I'm not ill.
Truthfully?
Everyone has nightmares.
So, what is yours?
Henry Head. He was working on the regeneration of nerve tissue. I helped him experiment on himself. Cut the radial nerve. Then tested him for sensation over a period of 4 years. My dream is that Henry hands me the scalpel. I refuse it. He cuts my arm anyway.
Yes, you're there in the trenches with them, aren't you? You need some time off.
Well, I could do with a few days in London, anyway. Louis Yellens invited me to witness his treatments.
That'll be restful.
He cures 100% of his patients.
Yes, so does death, William.
You're on the verge. Fatigue? Stress?
Powerlessness. That's what I told Pryor. Do you feel powerless with them?
I do not permit myself to feel that. I'm in charge.
Mr. Yellen's office?
Top of the stairs, turn left, sir.
Thank you. And you only have one session with him?
Oh, yes. Patient has to know when he enters the electrical room. The only way out is by a full recovery. Mons, the Marne, Ain, first and second Ypres, Hill 60, Luz, and Arras. Have I missed any? I've had dozens like you, Callan, dozens. Every one walked out of here fully cured. You will recover your speech. I usually do treatments alone. Last thing a patient's need is a sympathetic audience. Now then, Cullen, I expect you to behave like the hero you are. A man who's been through many battles, has good control of himself. I'm going to lock the door when the orderlies are gone. You will speak before you leave. There's no other way out. There is no alternative. Thank you. Nod if you wish to speak to me.
Let's try R and then bar. Now R and bar.
Dwarkada. Oh. Kada. Kada. Oh. Kada.
Ba. Ba.
Ka. I'll get you unstrapped now. Let you walk around for a little while.
Silly man, I've told you how you may leave. It's the only way. I'm prepared to be here all day, all night. You're not the doctor. I'm the doctor. I'll tell you when treatment will start again. Now walk up and down. Ah, ah,
ah. Come!
Yes, yes, you can have water as soon as you've spoken your first word. Now get back to the chair. Now this time, the electrical charge will be applied to the larynx. You will find it very much more painful, but it stimulates the very centers of speech. All right, a stronger current. Beg your pardon.
Stop it.
Say the days of the week.
Sunday. Monday. Tuesday.
1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6.
Are you not pleased to be cured?
Yes, sir.
Nothing else?
Thank you very much, sir.
I'd hate to think you felt your techniques were more humane. Just prolong the pain of these unfortunate men.
How is your Dr. Yellen?
He uses electricity and a metal mouth probe to great effect. I watched him treat a man for mutism. The only way he could protest. Sat there and watched his silence being taken away from him. The only thing that was important was getting him back to the front. He wasn't a man, he was... Well, he was a fighting unit being repaired.
You wouldn't do that.
The methods are almost miraculous.
Yes, but yours are gentler miracles. You wouldn't use pain.
No. No, I wouldn't. Not pain. Well, see if the boards.
Yes.
I can still hear the asthma.
It's fine.
If this is fine and all you're breathing is Highland air, how are you going to cope with gas?
Can always be the battalion canary. I won't be the only one there with asthma or TB.
Doesn't mean it's a good idea. I'm going to ask Dr. Samuel to have a look at you.
I want to go back.
It's up to the medical board to decide if you're fit to be discharged to duty.
Well, you can tell them.
Advise them. You're sure it's what you want?
Yes. When it's all over, those men who didn't acquit themselves, my generation, I mean, they aren't going to count for anything. And this is the club to end all clubs.
And do you want to be a member?
Yes.
But you already are.
No. I broke down.
Please don't.
An hour late.
Pryor, are you after Patterson?
Yes. Then you, then Thorpe.
Madness!
Excuse me, those are my... socks.
Good morning, Pryor.
Sit down, Pryor.
Are you sleeping through the night now?
Yes.
And how are you coping with the nightmares?
All right.
The medical board guidelines require we confirm that the symptoms which bring a man here no longer obtain. You're obviously not mute.
No.
Can you name the men in your platoon?
Yes.
Well, then do so.
Jones, Marby, Kelly, McLean, Angus, Mullen, Cobworth, Lucas, Josephs, Matthews.
Very good.
I was ill, I wasn't an idiot.
Have you seen Sasu?
He went out.
Out? He's got a board.
No.
But he just walked out? What time did the London train leave?
Surely you would have packed.
Like a lamb to slaughter.
Sorry.
Dr. Revels.
Mr. Campbell.
Never trusted a fella. He took a pair of my socks.
Excuse me.
Will you excuse us, Mr. Owen? I'm sure you have an explanation.
I was late for tea with a charming chap called Samson.
Damn you, Sassoon! Apart from the unforgivable discourtesy, disobeying a senior officer, the entire board, is a very serious offence.
I'm damned if I'm going in there to be judged by a bunch of nincompoops who've never fired a bullet or heard a mortar explode.
So... you decided to have tea
No, actually, I decided to lay siege to the House of Lords.
But you didn't.
I didn't.
Why not?
You?
I'm very grateful for the consideration. But turning up would have been a damn sight more considerate. You'll appear before the board or face the consequences.
You will take it easy at first, won't you?
Thanks for everything.
Yes. Everything was very little.
I'm all right now. Just a top up of sea air, some brisk walks.
Good luck.
Good luck, David.
Thank you, sir.
Not fit, damn it. He's not ready to go.
Medical boards make those decisions, will you?
Yes, well, they were wrong.
He's holding himself together, though.
So does an egg until you drop it.
Home service. They gave me home service. I'm never going to know about myself now, am I?
But you do know. You were a perfectly good officer.
Until I stopped being a perfectly good officer. My mother was always pulling me away from the ruffians who were my friends. Now here you are doing exactly the same bloody thing!
Dr. Rivers?
It's all right, miss, thank you. Prior, the decision wasn't in your hands. It was never your decision. Everybody who survives feels guilty. Don't let it spoil everything.
Thanks for putting up with me. Would you mind if I wrote to you when this is all over?
I don't see why you should wait till then.
All right.
Good luck.
Dead. And I knew them all. They're very quiet. They look puzzled. They want to know why I'm here.
And does the question have an answer?
I'm going back.
Really?
Yes.
I shan't ask why.
Oh, too many reasons.
Owen gave me one. I heard the sighs of men that have no skill to speak of their distress. No, nor the will. A voice I know. And this time, I must go.
Your pacifist friends won't be pleased.
No, I know. I'm not looking forward to that. You'll help me with the board, won't you?
We have to help each other. If you don't give up your protest, I don't know what I can do. That is, provided you turn up.
I'll be there. They must return me to active duty. It's the only thing I would never forgive you for.
Very slight residual pain from shoulder wound. Otherwise, physical health, excellent. How are the nightmares now, Mr. Sassoon?
I don't suffer from them anymore.
Hallucinations?
Not at all.
Dr. Rivers tells me that you've changed your mind about the war.
No, sir.
You haven't?
No, I believe exactly what I believed in July, more strongly, if that's possible.
I see.
Wasn't there something in the Times?
You feel it's your duty to go back?
Yes. Yes, I do, Captain.
No doubts?
None whatsoever.
But you will not recant your declaration?
No, sir. I will justify what I wrote. Precisely by going back to serve.
How interesting.
Are you sure about this, Rivers? He's not going to go back and foment rebellion in the ranks.
No, he won't do that. Nor anything to lower the morale of his men.
Do we see a reason? A medical reason for keeping him?
Spanish Jews. Father's side, Spanish Jews.
You know the family?
Yes. Mother was a Thornycroft. Oh, well, hybrid vigor.
Final word is yours, Rivers. Fit for duty?
Oh, yes. Yes.
You don't seem half as happy as I expected.
Your refusal to recant came as rather a shock.
Thank you. I could hardly lie.
Oh. You managed all right about the nightmares.
I'll be all right once I'm out of this place.
Or have them for the rest of your life.
Well, we're all wounded one way or another.
Aren't we?
You don't seriously think we haven't noticed?
Perhaps it's the protest of the old that will bring things to an end. Don't take unnecessary risks, Mad Jack.
You mean don't go looking for a martyr's death? You know me too well.
Congratulations, Rivers.
For what? Taking the same man and making him mad enough to go back to war?
But I've never seen him so happy.
Two poets on the front line.
Do you think he's mad?
This is for you, given to me by the author.
Thank you. It's really kind.
I've written you a dedication. Well, sort of.
When Captain Cook first sniffed the wattle, and love Columbus, Aristotle.
Parody of the writer's style.
Typical of you. The only half-demonstrative thing you've done, and you can't make it serious.
Do you think it's a good idea to be serious this morning?
I think I've written something good. Let me know what you think. I hope we meet in France. Be careful.
Thank you. Dear Dr. Rivers, a telegram arrived this morning. Owen was killed 2 days ago, crossing some bloody canal. I once told him that going back would be good for his poetry. I feel as if I sent him. He wrote the enclosed just before leaving. Thank you again for the gentle miracles. Yours ever, S. Sassoon.
So Abram rose and clave the wood and went and took the fire with him and a knife. And as they sojourned, both of them together, Isaac, the firstborn, spake and said, My father, behold the preparations, fire and iron, but where the lamb for this burnt offering? Then Abram bound the youth with belts and straps and builded parapets and trenches there and stretched forth the knife to slay his son. When lo, an angel called him out of heaven, saying, Lay not thy hand upon the lad, neither do anything to him, thy son. Behold, caught in a thicket by its horns, a ram. Offer the ram of pride instead. But the old man would not so, but slew his son and half the seed of Europe, one by one.